Let me just start by asking you this frank question. When was the last time that you bought something? Was it cheap or was it expensive? Did it live up to your expectation or just a total waste of money? Well, whatever it is, when it comes to buying something, we all, to some extent, have to make some financial decisions to see if we can afford it and not overspend on other necessary expenses in our lives. They say that if you buy what you want, you will end up losing money for what you need. But as I was saying, they say that if you buy what you want, you will end up losing money for what you need. But today, I would like to tell you guys about a time when I set my money aside for an item that suits both my favors and my daily needs, and that is my Casio AE1000WHD watch. So it all started when I fell in love with the world of watches in the summer last year, and on surfing the Casio webpage, the watch absolutely struck my heart. However, buying a seven-figure item back then was just extravagant for me, and the watch price tag was around 1.2 million Vietnam dong. So, without question, I gave up on my dream and carried on with my life. But there was something about that watch that makes me tingling, made me couldn't get that watch out of my head that easily. An obsession. It was the feeling of wanting to wear one of the most legendary item in the watch industry, highly appreciated by even some of the most fastidious enthusiasts all over the world. It was also the feeling of wearing a world time watch, on your wrists, with all the iconic Casio watch quirks and features, all for you to mess around. And so with all that motivations, or should I say, temptations, I began the journey to save my money to buy my dream watch. So, how did I save my money for my dream watch? Well, I took a part-time job as an office employee and started typing letters into document files. I was also involved in doing some graphs and sketches in the Microsoft Visio. Every time I done my work well, I received 100,000 Vietnam dong in my account. Aside from that, I also did the shipping job, including delivering products and papers to different addresses for my family business. Sometimes the location address is unfamiliar to me, so I had to use the Google Map to learn the roads properly. Of course, I do get lost sometimes, and delivery sometimes got delayed, and I had to use my money to cover up for my lateness, as well as my petrol fuels. The hardest part of saving money to me is not making money itself, but rather it is trying to spend your money as little as possible. Well, this is because I have friends, and every weekend they would call me out for a late night hangout. A night like that would cost me around 150,000 Vietnam dong, which equals to one sketch that I do and around 2 to 3 shipments that I make. And that lasts for around 2 to 3 months, which delayed my goal to save up money in only a month. Though I love my friends, I had to later make the hard decision to hold on my desire to go out and turn down their invitations. Of course, they were really sad to hear what I told them, but later on, I learned the lesson of saying no to people in order to focus on my objectives. And so after 3 months, I finally managed to save up my money for my dream watch. It was wonderful the moment that I managed to purchase that watch. And boy, was it useful. Not only did it make me be more on time in work, but also it acts truly as a friend, a companion, an essential item of fashion, and in day-to-day basis that hardly I can manage without. So with that being said, I will wrap up this video today. I hope you like my videos. Thank you for listening, and I would like to see you in the next video.